I have noted down for the teams. So, big clash. EU versus NA final. Very interesting, definitely. The game will start in around still 2 more minutes. Not all the players are ready. Not all the players are ready yet. So, Pond Guard. They have won multiple matches today, same for Eden. For Pond Guard, this is USA / Canada representative from the Wolf Syndicate House. And Eden team is Eden from EU1. It's mixed group of mixed nationalities. Both of them wanted to achieve first place and they have a big chance of doing so. This is best of three, so at least two games are awaiting us. Something to watch on. We are ready with the game. Guys, place your bets. We are starting the game in a moment. So I will be closing the bets in 1 minute. So when the match is starting. Let's see the sides, the attacking force for this side is Pond Guard. Game's green, so I have to switch. It's green, like so. Yeah, so Pond Guard on the left side, Eden defending. One less player is on Eden team, but maybe he crashed, he will reconnect in a moment. There is a possibility to remake, but hopefully we will not have to use it. Remember guys, this is the high stakes game. Both of the teams very skilled, very high level players. 2700 have the highest level blade shot from Eden. 2500 Kai the God from the Pond Guard team. All of the teams have a lot of players in the top 100 ranked. And all of them have a lot of achievements behind their back in territory wars and so on. So this is something to definitely keep an eye out. Okay, we are starting into the game. I am closing the bets right now. Thank you all for participating in the betting. And the responses are closed for the betting, so you cannot bet anymore. Brand Gaming, yes, it's fair. 14 versus 15, but the one player should load in shortly. If he will not load in, we will do a remake. It's up to the team captain to decide if he wants to do the remake. Thank you all for participating in the betting. Will be after the tournament, there will be the discussions with the... he loaded in. Okay, so no remake needed. Everyone will start with 15 at start, so good. After the tournament, we will be doing the short discussion with the tournament winner, and then there will be the betting tournament mission. For now, let's focus fully on these top teams. The final is here. Let's do the... very nicely closing in the trebuchet bait. The trebuchet was baited. So actually the Pond Guard seen the gate opening, and what they did is they reacted with nice trebuchet. It's only one trebuchet, so it's not a big deal, but definitely. And then what they did previously with the Hairy Cavalry Rush, this nice reaction to Pond Guard. Definitely they are making their notes. They are making their notes also into the game. So this is, you need to not only learn, but apply this experience. So this was nicely done. Let's quickly look before the game starts truly on the team compositions. So on Pond Guard team, we have many heavy armors, 3 muskets, 1 spear, so 4 medium armors. Everyone else heavy armor. While on the Eden team, we have 4 spears and 1 musket. So this is 5 medium armors, We have short bow and dual blades, so we have two light armors. So 7 people, not heavy armor, 8 heavy armor. Definitely something differently done over here. Alright. For now, no kills. Standard startup. All the towers are being pushed, artillery being destroyed, gate is being covered. Teams are getting ready to execute their plan. Let's see what units they have so far. On the pond guard, we have some Imperial Pikes, actually 5 of them. We have Stalwarts, very nice unit to push, to protect. They can survive a beating. Also, we have some Halabards in terms of Langnecks. They are nice to charge. The defensive side, a lot of Javelin Sergeants. Double shot definitely can do a lot of damage. Actually, there is 5 of them, so this is nice thing. We also see, is this, there are Namkans in the skin. I thought from the long range that these are longbows, but Namkans definitely doing their job, keeping Pond Guard at bay. Right now, Pond Guard, they have no one absolutely on the B point. They have not even moved the tower. So they are going to fully charge the B point. As you can see, they climb in, they are not even making the shields. They're just one shields are covering them. But look at that. One shields only. I wonder why Eden team is not more aggressive to counter their push here. But definitely they are aggressive with the aggression. Many players are rotating to protect the B. For now, only one person here. Let's see if it will be enough. For now, only one person. Okay, a few more have gone. That's good. The unit though, the problem with Pond Guard units, what they have chosen, mainly Pikes and Stalwarts, they are using slow units. They cannot run fast, they cannot flank fast. They would have more condottieris and units like that. They could be much more effective with their flank. But they changed their decision. Look at that. They have spotted an empty defense here and they are moving from the two sides. This is something we have not seen earlier too much. They are using both towers to attack the... They are using both towers to attack from both ends. And right now, the counter rotation from Eden is back. All the defenders are coming back, but you had that the flag in the middle is splitting the forces exactly in the half. We have forces on the left from Eden and forces on the right from Pond Guard. But Eden have something up their sleeve. They are moving back from the stairs and attacking the Pond Guard in the back. This is something that can be key, this attack. For now, a lot of people have been killed. We have 5 people dead. A lot of units have been lost. You can see the Pond Guard, the attack is slowly getting bled out. The Namkans here doing the key work. The longer they work, the longer they can do their work, the longer they can shoot, the longer the fight is there, the more damage they do. Their initial arrow damage is quite poor, but they apply bleeding stacks, which last for quite long time, and they multiply. So with one stack only, or two stacks, if you get hit by like 2 arrows, you don't receive too much bleeding damage. But if you get few more arrows inside of you, and this is stacked up to like 8 or 10 arrows in you, and the bleeding damage is stacked, then you are really, really having a lot of bleeding damage on you. This works on units, heroes. So the one Namkan unit in the very long fights can be worth than more than three infantry units in my opinion. Right now, Pond Guard, they have slowed down, they have seen what they tried didn't work, and they are making some changes. They are pushing the battering ram right now, so possibly they will also try to flank the enemy from the stairs. We have to see about that, how it will work. Let's make some cinematic camera for a moment. Looks like they are starting to prepare the attack. We can watch through the nice cinematics on the Eden team. You can see some skins are applied. Most of the units though on their standard skins. That's something unusual, I would say, for the tournament server where we have a lot of options to equip skins. The gate is broken and they have seen it. Eden team have seen it, they have rotated. Will it be good rotation? Will they rotate fast enough? The Pond Guard team is coming in heavy. The Pond Guard team, look at that. They are very heavily pushing through the main gate. The force from the walls, that was just a distraction. All of them came down and they are through. All the front line of Eden is down. All the pikes are down. All the shields are down. They are making slow and steady progress. So Pond Guard, very effective on their push. They brute forces their way through the main gate. They didn't knock, they just used their feet to knock down the doors. But very good, Eden. Nice idea. Three horses from three different directions at similar time pushing. Unfortunately, Pond Guard not having any of this. They were ready. A lot of pikes were there to counter all of this. Right now, two more horses coming from the back. Let's see if the counter will be there. Not enough pikes. Some horses came through, destroyed a lot of units. And seems like the attackers, Pond Guard, are bleeding out. Idea was great. They made a lot of progress, but Eden, they had all under control and they retreated slowly. They didn't overestimate their force. They give enough of pressure while retreating so they cannot be crushed, but they did it respectfully. You can very clearly see that both these teams are top of the top on their respective servers. Definitely very highly skilled players, and I would love to hear the communications inside the teams. I am sure that the commanders of the battle are right now very heavily shouting on the players. Game is very balanced. Both of the teams lost a lot of the units, and the battle is still not over. 3 minutes left. This is going to be last push probably from Pond Guard. Let's see if they will do it. In the meantime, looking at the units, 659 units left on the Pond Guard, 900 almost lost. On the side of Eden, 900 units left, 400 lost. So definitely big advantage here, Eden side. They can play it safe, they can play it on time. When it comes to the units, that was Sumare. When it comes to the hero skills, similar. Pond Guard, 15 people died. Eden, only 7. Remember, in this tournament, each player has 3 lives on them. And on the side of Pond Guard, I can see that already 3 players have 1 life left, so they cannot allow themselves to die anymore, or they will play in disadvantage till the end of the match. Pond Guard is pushing. 2 minutes left. They really need to step their game up and run those legs. 2 minutes is not long time if you consider that so many heavy armor and pull are playing, and you can defend the point for quite long time. The standard push is coming to the B point. Let's see if they will be using middle stairs or the back stairs. This is not clear yet. Definitely, Pond Guard are having some special plan in mind because they are not attacking everyone. Maybe this is just a distraction on the B point. A point is getting captured. The Eden team is having trouble deciding how many people they need to commit to each point. The Eden team right now looks like they have quite a lot of people on A, and they are moving more over there. So this might be the nail to the coffin for the team. The archers, one player blade shot, one of the MVPs from the previous game, is clearing out the archers nicely, and Eden team nicely working on A. But in the meantime, the push had happened. Pond Guard walked down the stairs. They had no players there from the Eden team to defend, and right now the fight is for the plus. 1 minute 15 left. There is very small amount of time, and Pond Guard need to step up their game. The cap here is being fight for the plus, right? But in the meantime, the A, look at that. This is what I was talking about. They had this plan. They knew that they cannot crush them. They have to use time to their advantage. They have to use the rotations. They have to create chaos. And the Pond Guard did it. They did it. They have half of A point capture. The B point in the meantime is fully done, and they have only 40 seconds left. All of the players, or like most of the players right now, will rotate to the A, and let's see if the Pond Guard have enough players to do it. They have only 6 people alive, and I am afraid with 30 minutes on the clock, this is not going to be good for the Pond Guard team. Eden, they have A point under control with a lot of heroes. They have B point under control. 17 seconds left. The game is over. GG. Nice fight, guys. let me drink something for a moment, because this was really interesting and engaging fight, and we will do to the post-game analysis. All right, music is out. Let's talk quickly, as the next game is happening shortly, for the statistics. So on the attacking side of Pond Guard, we have 2 kills on the Tuzzle and 3 kills on Kai, 2 kills on Onomi. So a few highlights here. Easy peasy baby, 2 kills once more. Player of Easy Peasy is doing a lot of kills today. For the unit kills, 60 for 3 players, and we have the almost 80 on ABG. So that's the highlight player. Definitely few of the players tried to capture the points, and they achieved a lot of points capturing A flag, but they were not able to finish the capture, unfortunately. On the winning side, the Eden won the first round. We have the highlight for the kills on Ghost Decks for 4 kills and Bladeshot 4 kills again. Bladeshot, I believe, has most or either second most kills across all the games, so very nicely performing player. On the unit kills, 120 on all Hydra. I believe this player once more has the most unit kills in the Eden team. So definitely very well performed, very well performing player. Few other players, a lot kills, over 100. So nicely executed defense from Eden team. They have reacted nicely, and the battle was very, very nice. We have about 3 more minutes to go to the next game, so let me quickly go through the battle. So basically a lot of things happened at the beginning. Pond Guard tried to get in, they tried to rotate to B, they faked the rotation, they moved back to A. A lot of fighting happened here on A. Unfortunately, Eden prevailed and they have killed lots of Pond Guard team. This first push was very brutal and very many units of Pond Guard were lost in the process. Then what they did is they tried to resupply themselves, push for the gate. The gate push was very effective, and at the beginning it looked very, very nicely. Pond Guard have breaked through the main front line of Eden. They have killed all their shields, their pikes very quickly, and they started to rotate towards the plus and stairs, which is key. Plus resupply point is key for the defenders. If you cannot resupply, you will bled out. So whoever can resupply is the upper hand, and that's why these teams are focusing the supply points so much. Unfortunately for Pond Guard, Eden team very well played on the horses. They had around 3 or 4 cavalry units at this time, and they constantly pressured the attacking side from many different angles with horses. Attack bled out and couldn't continue. Pond Guard restructurized, prepared with very little time left, 2-3 minutes left. They have prepared the push, they have moved heavily to the B side, but they seen that the Eden is over rotating, so they moved to, so they left a few people on A, and the fight at B was lost due to the Eden team having more players. But the people left on the back on the A point from Pond Guard actually were quite successful. They captured about 60% of the point. It was not enough though. So this is summary of the game. Let's jump to the match.